यस सर,
हेलो,
गुड इवनिंग सर।
हाउ आर यू ऐश्वर्या?
आई एम फाइन सर।
ओके, तो आपने रिवीजन किया ज्योग्राफी का? जो मैंने रिवीजन करने के लिए बताया था लास्ट 2-3 डेज, आई हैव गिवन यू द टाइम टू रिवाइज द टॉपिक्स व्हिच आई हैव टेकन इन ज्योग्राफी।
हाँ सर, एक्चुअली मैं वो एमपीएससी का स्टडी कर रही थी, तो मैं साइंस कवर कर रही थी।
ठीक है, तो एमपीएससी स्टेट सर्विस एग्जाम का।
हाँ
ठीक है, तो कब एग्जाम कब है?
अभी 11 तारीख को, नेक्स्ट मंथ।
ठीक है, और आप साइंस पढ़ रहे थे?
हाँ
ठीक है, चलिए कोई बात नहीं, अभी आप
बस
पढ़ रहे
रिवाइज
हो। ठीक है, कोई प्रॉब्लम, अगर आप पढ़ रहे हो तो कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है, बट अगेन आई विल टेल यू कि एमपीएससी में साइंस की आप कितनी भी पढ़ाई करके जाओ, एग्जाम में उतने ही सवाल को के आंसर निकलते हैं जितना तुमने स्कूल में पढ़ा है। Because science is very, very, what you can say, unpredictable in MPSC. हाँ, in UPSC you can predict science and technology, but in MPSC it's very difficult to predict because they do ask questions from core science. Anyways, we will discuss about MPSC later on. But anyways, can you please give me the topics which we have studied in the UPSC from geography since beginning? I guess you are from the since beginning, like we have attended all the topics of geography. तो अब तक हमने क्या क्या पढ़ा है ज्योग्राफी में, वो थोड़ा सा ब्रॉडली टॉपिक्स बता सकते हो? बिकॉज क्या होता है कि when I keep starting the classes one, एक के बाद मैं क्लास लेता रहूंगा, और अगर आप रिवाइज नहीं करोगे तो पिछला क्या हुआ वो याद नहीं रहेगा ना, तो ऑब्वियसली फिर इट विल बिकम वेरी डिफिकल्ट फॉर मी व्हाट यू कैन से कंटिन्यू विद द नेक्स्ट सब्जेक्ट। सो आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू नो, आर यू रियली, बिकॉज मैं 1 घंटा पढ़ाऊंगा लेकिन आई want you to go and read and revise. That's a very, very important part in UPSC exam. Revision, question paper and newspaper. These are the 3 important basic things which you need to know, which you need to do continuously for qualifying UPSC exam. Revision, question paper, newspaper. These 3 things are what you can say the success mantra for you. Yes, Aishwarya. Shuruaat se leke ab tak humne geography ke kaun se topics kiye hain? Can you just enumerate? Or just give a list of the topics which are studied till now. Yes.
पहले हमने वो mountains and all, वो formation, वो सब geographic formation किया था।
सबसे पहले तो हमने I guess origin of universe पढ़ा था, याद है?
Yes.
Origin of universe, like what is geography and origin of universe. उसके बाद?
उसके बाद यही तो फिजिकल ज्योग्राफी, फिर वो माउंटेन्स कैसे फॉर्म हुए, सी कैसे फॉर्म हुआ वो सर।
देयर आर 2 थ्योरीज रिलेटेड टू द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द अर्थ, व्हिच आर दोस 2 थ्योरीज व्हिच आर स्टडीड? यस, सो वी आफ्टर ओरिजिन ऑफ यूनिवर्स वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द कॉन्टिनेंटल ड्रिफ्ट थ्योरी एंड वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द प्लेट टेक्टोनिक्स।
एम आई राइट? यप,
कॉन्टिनेंटल ड्रिफ्ट थ्योरी एंड प्लेट टेक्टोनिक्स। So on the basis of that plate tectonic theory and continental drift theory, we have studied that how the various landforms on the earth surface are created, right? How the continents are created, how the oceans are created, that we have already discussed, right? Then we have discussed about the types of movements like endogenetic moment and exogenetic moment, right? There are certain landforms which are formed on the surface of the earth because for the, what you can say, due to the endogenetic moment, that is due to the internal forces. And some landforms are formed on the and formed as well as their form is changed due to the external or taken to the factors like erosion, deposition, weathering, that we have discussed, right? So internal, again within internal, that we have already discussed, like that is sudden moment and isotropism, that we have already discussed, right? After that, what we have discussed, we have discussed about the world physical geographies, what you can say the salient feature, like we have discussed about all the continents and where in which continents which type of mountains are found, which type of deserts are found, then which rivers are found, what are the physical features of all the 7 continents that we have discussed, like Africa, South America, North America, then Asia, Europe, Australia, then what you can say Antarctica, these all we have discussed world physical features, right? Then we have discussed about atmosphere, am I right? Atmosphere, yes, structure and composition of atmosphere. Then structure and composition of atmosphere. After that, we have discussed about the different elements of weather, that is temperature, pressure, winds, then pressure belts. Then we have discussed about the latitudes and longitudes. then shifting of the pressure belts, and how the shifting of the pressure belt leads to what you can say creation of a certain type of climate. Then we have discussed about the climatic types of the world, right? So there are how many climatic types of the world? Can anybody tell me how many climatic types we have discussed?
11 types of climate.
So can you give me the list of those 11 types of climate? Which those climates we have discussed? Yes, Sana. Which are those 11 types of climates?
Equatorial climate, western desert, Sudan savanna, monsoon, Mediterranean, steppe, China, British, Siberian, Laurentia.
And last one is tundra or polar climate. Right, perfect. So these are the 11 types of these are the 11 types of climates we have seen, and then we have discussed about the oceanic currents, oceanic tides that we have discussed, and how these oceanic currents and oceanic tides influences on the human activities or human what you can say geography that we have discussed. Right. So today I am going to start with all of you geography of India. Right. So whatever we have discussed till now, we have studied about the geography, that is physical geography, economic geography, and human geography in terms of world geography. But today we are going to study geography of India in detail. Right? Already we have discussed the monsoon type of climate as in the world climatic types. But there we have discussed a broad characteristics of the monsoon type of climate. Now since we all live in India, we have to magnify. We have to, what you can say, go in detail and find out and study the geography of India, right? So physical geography of India, economic geography of India, human, what you can say, the population geography of India, and we are also going to discuss about what you can say, the industrial geography of India, right? So there are various topics which we are going to discuss about the geography of India, right? So what we study in geography, can anybody tell me? What normally we study in geography that we have already discussed. So what we study in geography, yes, Mr. King? Can you tell me what we study in geography?
Graph of the world.
Graph of the earth, right? But when I'm talking about the geography of India,
earth surface.
Yes. So when I'm saying we are going to study the geography of the India, it means that we are going to first discuss about the graph of the India, graph like geographical graph of the India. Geographical graph of the India means what? Physical features of India. Physical features means what? Where the mountains are located, where the plains are located, where the plateaus are located, where the islands are located. So first we are going to discuss about this physical geography of India. Like the first important thing, as we have already discussed, that the location of any country decides the climate, decide the season, decide that is when there will be rainfall and when there will be no rainfall, when there will be winter, when there will be summer, what is the amount of rainfall, what is what you can say the crops, what type of what you can say the clothes the people wear, all these things are decided on the basis of location of that, right? We have seen that there are 11 types of climatic types in the world, and each climatic type have their unique characteristics. Unique characteristics in terms of rainfalls, then winter, then what you can say, the crop types of crops which they are growing. All these things, what you can say, decides the human development as well, right? So that's the reason, the first and very, very important topic which we are going to study about the geography of India today is the size of the Indian geography, that's India, and also location and extent of the India. Got it? So can anybody tell me where India is located on the globe? India is located in the northern hemisphere or in the southern hemisphere? Anyone knows where India is located? Because we have seen that while discussing the world geography, we have seen that the earth is divided into two hemispheres. There is north hemisphere and south hemisphere, right? So equatorial line is there. So 0 degree line, that is 0 degree latitudinal line. So above 0 degree latitude, it is called north hemisphere, and below we have south hemisphere, right? So can anybody tell me where India is located? India is located in the north hemisphere or India is located in the south hemisphere?
North.
India is located in the north hemisphere. Very good. And is it in the northeast or northwest? Because again we see on the basis of longitudinal, what you can say, the location, again, the whole world is divided into east and west, right? So, where the 0 degree latitudinal line
passes?
Northeast. Very good. One second. Can all see the screen? Is it visible to all of you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, so India, in world, if you see, India lies in the northeastern hemisphere. So you got it? The location of India is what? Northeastern hemisphere. Northeastern hemisphere means India lies in the on the globe in the northern hemisphere and the eastern hemisphere, right? So I will take the world map so that exactly we'll come to know where India is located. Check. So now this is the physical map of India. Can you all see the world map? Check. Is it visible to all of you? Can you all see the screen?
Yes, sir.
Check it. Yes, now here sir, you can see here from the middle of Africa, the equatorial line passes, right? So I will take one image of 1 second, which will help us in understanding. Yes. Fine. So this line is equatorial line. So equatorial line passes from middle of Africa and from what you can see here. So India lies in the northeastern. Now this is the standard, international standard line, longitudinal line, which is 0 degree line. So India lies in the northeastern hemisphere. So the location of India is in the northeastern hemisphere. And here you can see that although India lies in the northeastern hemisphere, India lies in which zone? India lies in the equatorial zone. And India lies in the 10 to 30 degree latitude, eastern margin or western margin or middle of the continent. Do you remember that the world climatic types are divided on the basis of their location, right? So India's location is between 10 to 30 degree latitude in the eastern margin of the continent. Am I right? And because of that unique location of India, that is in 10 to 30 degree latitude in the eastern margin of the continent, the type of climate which is found in India is called as monsoon type of climate. Is it clear? Now we will see about in detail about the monsoon type of climate. But now we will go for what you can say the location and also exact location of India. What is India's exact location, right? Now 1 second. So can you all see the map of India now?
In Wikipedia,
there is an image here, right hand side. So this is the satellite image of India, which shows that India lies in north of what you can say the equator. And here you can see here Himalayas are located. And India's this part, ye jo green wala jo part dikh raha hai, sorry, the yellow wala jo part dikh raha hai, this part has been what you can say attached to the Eurasian plateau. So we are going to study about the geological history of India. Geological history means what? How the mountains are formed in India, how the plains are formed in India, how the valleys are formed in India, and how the islands of India are formed. So geological history is very, very important, what you can say the part of understanding the geography of India. If you understand the geological history of India, then you will understand all other remaining topics of geography of India, right? So India lies on the Indian plate. Do you remember in plate tectonics theory, we have seen that the whole earth is divided into various tectonic plates. So India lies on the, what you can say, India lies on the Indian plate. Now actually this Indian plate was originally a part of African plate, right? Indian plate was actually originally a part of what you can say the African plate. Now I will show you how exactly what you can say it was a part of African plate. Can you all see here this image? So this is actually the Indian plate which was attached to the Africa. If you see the world map, in the world map you can see this Indian plate was actually attached here in Africa, which got broken due to the plate tectonics that we have seen. That due to plate tectonics, the whole plates are moving away from each other or towards each other. So due to internal forces, this plate, Indian plate, was a part of this Africa. It started breaking down from Africa slowly, slowly, slowly. It moved and now it is attached to Eurasian plate now. It means what? Okay, now here, whatever you can see here, that this part, this triangular part, which is called as the peninsular or which is called as the Deccan Plateau of India, this triangular part was once upon a time, that is around 200 million years ago. It was a part of Africa, but it got broken from Africa and slowly it moved towards north, and now it is attached to Europe. It is attached to Eurasia, and here there is a suture zone. Suture zone means what? It is a meeting point between the Eurasian plate and Indian plate. So geologically, if we see geologically, history wise, India is not the part of Asia. It is actually a part of Africa. But after like moment of 200 million, slowly, it was what you can say attached to the Indian, Indian plate attached to the Eurasian plate. So can you see here? This is an Indian plate. Slowly it moved, and after it attached here. So this was an Eurasian plate. So it means what? कि जहाँ अभी ये India है, यहाँ पर कुछ समय पहले, that is around 200 million years ago, here there was a complete what you can say the ocean, and this ocean got converted into a geosyncline, that is Tethys geosyncline, or there was a Tethys Sea here between what you can say Eurasian plateau and Indian plateau, and since this Indian plateau got attached to the Eurasian plateau, now that Tethys Sea is submerged. एंड जहां पर टेथिस था वहां पर अभी हिमालयन माउंटेन रेंजेस इन द नॉर्दर्न पार्ट. सो आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द जियोलॉजिकल हिस्ट्री ऑफ इंडिया इन डिटेल इन टुमारोज क्लास. सो हियर यू नीड टू रिमेंबर दैट इंडिया लाइज ऑन द इंडियन प्लेट, द नॉर्दर्न पार्ट ऑफ इंडो ऑस्ट्रेलियन प्लेट, हुज कॉन्टिनेंटल कस्ट फ्रॉम द इंडियन सब कॉन्टिनेंट. अब इंडियन सब कॉन्टिनेंट मीन्स हियर यू कैन सी व्हाई इट इज कॉल्ड एज इंडियन सब कॉन्टिनेंट, बिकॉज This part of the Asia, actually India lies in Asia continent, right? All of you know, India lies in what? India lies in Asia. All of you know this. But actually,
yes, sir.
The physical feature and geological feature of India is different than Asia, because ये Asia जो है, ये Laurentia का part था, और ये India ये Gondwana land का part था. आपको सबको याद है? शुरुआत में जब मैंने आपको बताया था कि there was a land supracontinent, a large supracontinent in the beginning, as per the continental drift theory, and that is called as Pangaea. This Pangaea was broken down into two continents, that is Gondwana land and Laurentia. So this upper part of the world, this is actually a part of Gondwana land, and your niche ka jo part hai, this is the part, sorry, the upper part is of the part of the Laurentia, aur ye niche wala jo part hai ye Gondwana land ka part hai. Africa, South America, Australia, all, even India, these are actually the parts of what you can say the Gondwana land. So this India was a part of Africa once upon a time. It got separated from Africa due to plate tectonic movement, and now it got attached to the Laurentian part. Here it is an attachment. So obviously the geological features of Laurentia and geological features of this part are different, and that is why it is called a subcontinent. Geologically, this is a subcontinent. Asia is the main continent, but India is a subcontinent. I mean, Indian subcontinent, actually all the countries like Pakistan, Afghanistan, then even Bangladesh, then Sri Lanka, Nepal, Bhutan, all these countries are actually the part of Indian subcontinent. Got it? Any doubts about it? Yes, Ritika, you have raised that. Any doubts? Any doubts about the location of India?
No, sir.
Check it. Now, to be precise, if you want to see where exactly the India is located, the country is situated on the north of equator between 8.4 degree north. Now, 8.4 degree north means what? This is an equatorial line. This is red line and equatorial line. So exactly India lies from this equator line to, that is here, 8.07 degree latitude. So from equator, India's exact location begins from 8.4 north to 37.6 north latitude. So here you can see 8.4 to 37. So the northern tip of the country, like you can see here, the northern tip of the country is at the 6 north latitude and 8.4 in the south latitude. So south is Andaman and Nicobar here. And east and west, what you can say the extent of the India, east and west extent of India, from the international standard line, it is 68.7 east. It means what? ये जो international जो standard line है जो यहाँ से जाती है, this is an international standard line. यहाँ से India का location 67.7 degree latitude पे. So ये, if you consider this line as a zero, then from this zero to eastward, 67.7 east and 97.25 east. So 97 means यहां से अगर आप देखोगे यहां से this is the equatorial sorry the Indian international standard line. From here 67 the western part and the eastern part lies in 97. Something. How much is? It is 97.25 east longitude. So this is India's longitudinal and latitudinal location. So India lies in east and north hemisphere, right? So all the latitudes of India are in eastern hemisphere and in the northern hemisphere. So how you need to remember about it? 8.4 to 37.6, then 68.7 to 97.2. Now earlier UPSC do used to ask this factual information exactly. क्वेश्चन पूछा करते थे बट अब नाउअडेज दे आर नॉट आस्किंग जस्ट यू जस्ट नीड टू रिमेंबर इज दैट कि इंडिया लाइज बिटवीन 8 टू 37 नॉर्थ लैटिट्यूड एंड 68 टू 97 ईस्ट लैटिट्यूड्स इन टर्म्स ऑफ सॉरी लॉन्जिट्यूड राइट सो नाउ एज आई टोल्ड यू दिस स्पेसिफिक लोकेशन व्हाई इट इज इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज दिस हेल्प्स अस इन अंडरस्टैंडिंग द क्लाइमेटिक टाइप बिकॉज वी हैव सीन दैट द क्लाइमेटिक टाइप्स बिटवीन 10 टू 30 डिग्री लैटिट्यूड सो On an average, like broadly, we can say that India lies between the 10 to 30 degree latitude eastern margin of the continent, and that is why we have monsoon type of climate. And this location is actually the reason for the reversal of the wind in India in certain season. Like for certain season, the wind blows from southwest to the northeast, that is from sea towards land, and for certain season, the wind blows. From what you can say the northeast to the southwest, that is from land to sea. So this particular reversal of the wind leads to monsoon type of climate. That is what is influences the cropping pattern, the economic activities, the clothing pattern, as well as what you can say the economic activities in India. So that is why location is very important. So that you need to remember. In terms of size, India is the seventh largest country in the world size-wise, with total area of around 32 lakh square kilometer. So you just need to remember this amount. That is India's total size is 32 lakh square kilometer. Then India measures 3124 from north to south. From north to south means what? From northern tip of the India to the southern tip of India, that is around 3214 kilometer. From the north to south and 2933 kilometer from east to west. Now, can anybody tell me India's north-south extent is what you can say the distance is more or the east-west distance is more lengthwise? Hello, hello. Am I audible?
Sir, north-south.
Yes. So India's north-south extension is more compared to the east-west extension. So east-west is around 2933 kilometer, that is around 3000 kilometer, and south-north is around 32,000 kilometer. So there is a 2000 kilometer difference between the northeast and southeast extent that you need to remember. Because sometimes in UPSC they used to ask such question, like for example they used to give two statement that India's southwest sorry northeast extent is longer than the east west extent. So the statement is correct or wrong that they used to ask earlier. Nowadays we can see why I'm taking this in detail, because UPSC is asking such question in last 2-3 years. Like for example, last year they have asked one question that what is India's westernmost and easternmost states. Political maps based question pucha gaya tha, so you need to know about it, right? Again, we can see that India has a land frontier, that is the total border of India is around 15,200 kilometer, while the coastline is around 7,500-600. आप मुझे यहाँ पे बताइए कि the India's border land border is more or the sea border is more lengthwise? Because out of total 15,200 kilometer land frontier, that is land, what you can say the land border is 15,000. While the coastline, that is this the coastal what you can say the border area is around 7500. So land is more compared to what you can say the water. Now on the south, India projects into that is bounded by Indian Ocean. Then obviously south of India we have Indian Ocean. So world map you can see that south of India we have Indian Ocean. It is located south of India, that is why it is called as Indian Ocean, right? Then next is that, and by Arabian Sea on the west, here this water body is called as Arabian Sea, and this body is called as Bay of Bengal. Now it is sea and it is bay. Why it is bay? Because bay means any part of the, what you can say, the world where the water is intruded into land mass, that is what is called as bay. And this is called as peninsula. Ye jo India ka jo triangular jo shape ka jo land mass hai, which is intruded into the sea, so this is called as peninsula. Right? Marathi madhe peninsula la ka mantat dvipkalp. Right? It is called as Indian Dvipkalp or Indian Peninsula. So this landmass is called as peninsula, and on this peninsula, on the western side we have Arabian Sea, and in the eastern side we have Bay of Bengal. So and the Lakshadweep Sea at the here we have Lakshadweep Sea, and here we have Andaman and Nicobar Sea. That is what is mentioned here. So the Palk Strait and the Gulf of Mannar separates India from Sri Lanka to its immediate southeast. So here you can see, between India and Sri Lanka there is a strait. Strait means a narrow channel of water body which separates two land masses. That is what is called a strait. So here India and Sri Lanka is separated by a narrow channel of water, that is called as Palk Strait, right? So Palk Strait and Gulf of Mannar separate India from Sri Lanka to its immediate south, and Maldives are some 125 kilometers. So Maldives islands are located here, south of what you can see, the south of Lakshadweep Island. So Maldives islands are located. So these are the southern, what you can say, the neighbors of our country. So then border neighboring countries, we will see that India is bordered by what you can say, the various countries. Like we can see that on border of India, we have neighboring countries actually. So first I'll go to the neighbor one second. Political geography. Yes, we can see political geography here. Okay, anyways, here you can see that here is Sri Lanka, here we have Maldives, and here we have Pakistan. So on the northwestern part we have Pakistan, and one second, let me have a Asia map. Okay, fine. So can you all see the map? Is it visible to you?
Yes, sir.
Asia map is visible, right? So bordering nations of India, that is important. In bordering Asia, we can see a country, that is Pakistan. Then we have China, and we have some part of Afghanistan. Now this is what you can say, this is not an official map of India, but here we can see, here you can see Pak occupied Kashmir is shown in Pakistan. So if we consider that, then Afghanistan is not directly, what you can say, bordering India. But as per India's claims, Afghanistan is also bordering India. So Pakistan, Afghanistan, China, then Bhutan, Nepal, and Myanmar, these are the countries which have direct, what you can say, the boundaries which are shared with India, right? So how many countries are there? Pakistan, Afghanistan, then China, Bhutan, Nepal, Myanmar, and Bangladesh. So these are the countries which are bordering India. Sri Lanka and Maldives are the neighboring countries, but they are not directly sharing their boundary with India. So between Sri Lanka and India, we have a strait, and that is what is called as political strait. Sorry, a Palk Straits, right? So this we need to, what you can say, remember here, right? Again, one more very, very important features of India, Indian, what you can say, the location wise. And we can say that from the middle of India, a very, very important, what you can say, the line passes, and that is called as Tropic of Cancer. All of you know this, that from the middle of India, Tropic of Cancer passes. So can anybody tell me what is the significance of passing of this Tropic of Cancer from the middle of India? What could be the significance, geographical significance of it? Humne already world geography padha hai, aur humne dekha hai ki why this Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn are important. So what is the significance of this? Yes, can anybody tell me? We are left with 4 minutes. So I just want to discuss this particular aspect and then we will stop. Yes, can anybody tell me why, what is the significance of Tropic of Cancer being passed from the middle of India?
Sir, due to the low pressure and the high pressure, due to the low pressure in the equator, from the Tropic of Cancer, the air flows from Tropic of Cancer to equator due to the pressure
climate.
Okay, fine. ठीक है. अब यहाँ पर आप देख सकते हो कि Tropic of Cancer passes from the middle of India, and we know that Tropic of Cancer is the limit of apparent movement of sun towards the north and towards south, right? So Tropic of Cancer का significance यह है कि this part of the country, that is south of Tropic of Cancer, experiences temperature throughout the year, because throughout the year sun is here, right? यहाँ पर sun होता है, and that's the reason India has what you can say the tropical type of climate. This part of the country has tropical type of climate, but again due to the presence of Himalaya, we do not exactly experience the tropical climate, but we experience the subtropical type of climate. But anyways, Tropic of Cancer का importance ये है, because इसकी वजह से sun, like in summer, the sun lies exactly in the middle of India. Sun rays are directly falling on the middle of India, and that is why temperature is very high. And because of that temperature, a low pressure is created in the middle of the India. And because of this low pressure, the wind blows from high pressure Indian Ocean, and that leads to what you can say the monsoon rainfall in India. Got it? So climatic significance of Tropic of Cancer is that because of Tropic of Cancer, there is an apparent movement of the sun till the Tropic of Cancer, and that leads to creation of a low pressure belt in the northern India, and that leads to what you can say the southwest monsoon, which is an important aspect of the agricultural, what you can say, the development in India. Am I right? So here we can see, yes, the from which state the Tropic of Cancer passes. So you can see the Tropic of Cancer passes from Gujarat, then some part of Rajasthan, then Madhya Pradesh, then Chhattisgarh, then Jharkhand, then Odisha, and then Bangladesh and Tripura, and what you can say the last is Tripura and I guess Mizoram. So on in this, what you can say, the state the Tropic of Cancer passes. So before this, we need to know the political map of India. Political map of India means what? You know, yes, geographic divisions of India is again divided into 4 types. That we are going to discuss in tomorrow's class. But political map means there are 29 states and some union territories in India. So where all these states are located, that we need to see, right? So tomorrow we will start with the political map, and we will also start about the physiographic regions of India. Geographical map is different and political map is different. So today, tomorrow, we are going to discuss about that physiographic map and geographic map. So today you have to go and check it out. India's location, size and extent. There is one 11th standard NCERT, India physical, India physical. So 11th standard NCERT, all of you have to go and read it today itself. You have to read the first chapter of that NCERT, that is India's size, location and extent. Fine. I will share it in the group also. I will share that NCERT. Along with that, I will also share a notes on the group, that our, what you can say, the PDF. So you have to read this particular topic today. And if you don't get it anywhere, then please go through Wikipedia. In Wikipedia also, you will get this information. India's location, size and extent and neighboring countries. So that you have to do it today. Any doubts, Ritika?
No, sir. Got it.
Ritika, Aishwarya, Anand, all of you got it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, chali. So we'll stop it here today. Tomorrow we'll continue with the physiographic divisions of India. Fine? That is physical geography of India.
So will we have the newspaper analysis today?
Yes, we'll have it at 7:30. I will send you the link soon.
All right, sir.